Well, you knew what sort of game to expect before the match. You told us what you expected from Watford. In the end, it was a very fine margin, almost a couple of millimeters.
Yeah, but that's the way it is. I know that it's a couple of millimeters, but the goal line technology doesn't make mistakes like the VAR makes. So we have to accept that by 2 millimeters was not a goal.
And what did you make of the Tottenham performance?
The Tottenham performance separate from referee and VAR decisions, because I prefer not to comment. Tottenham performance was good. We start very, very well. We had immediately a situation after 1 minute or a couple of minutes. We were very dominant in the first half until they had what they always have, which is that period where they start winning a couple of more second balls, they put long balls in the box, they have one or two crosses, one or two set plays, which is impossible to be always dominant against them. In the second half, I think the game was more 50-50, not as much dominant we were in the first half, and then we tried with the ammunition we have. We tried in the last period to bring energy, to bring more depth from midfield with Jetson, with more vision, more quality from Eriksen, and as you told, we were 2 millimeters from winning the match. But I think overall, was a good match.
Just to be clear on the decisions that you're unhappy, was it Kapu's high tackle on Tanganga and then the follow-up yellow card? I know you don't want to comment.
There are various decisions, but I live for you. I live for the pundits. I live for the referees, specialists to do. I prefer not to speak more than what I did.
Gazzaniga, of course, made the penalty save. He stepped up very well in Lloris's absence, hasn't he?
Yeah, he did his job for us, and today, of course, is an important save. I think we deserve to win this match. To lose would be too much of a punishment for the boys. So I think they did good work, and Paulo, I think, was the only save that he had for the 90 minutes. For me, the important thing is so many positive things from the team. A good attitude, a good competitive attitude. We arrived here and we played without a part of the back four. We played without one single defensive player. Winks, you can say a link player, and after that, Dele Alli is an offensive player. Lo Celso it is, Lamela, Lucas, Sonny, no striker, but no defensive player. So we try to go in the direction of control the possession, play behind them, play in between the lines, overload some areas where we have players with quality, and we had so many, I don't say clear situations, I don't want to say so many, but I say so many opportunities to create goal situations in the last third. Defensively, we were okay. We were in a difficult situation because, as I was used to say, it's impossible to press a ball that goes in the air. They go long, and then you have to adapt. And I don't think Tottenham is or was a very good team adapting to this kind of football. The boys behind Vertonghen, Aurier, Alderweireld, Tanganga, they did a good job for the team. We won lots of second balls in front, so we were quite comfortable.
Ya que nos encontraste, no nos pierdas. Suscríbete a nuestro canal de YouTube de Telemundo Deportes.